I felt that.
I wanted to go ahead and dedicate episode 10 to none other than Miss Whitney Houston. Yes. Film producer, philanthropist, record producer, songwriter. She did pop, R&B, gospel, dance. She did it all. Soul. She did it all. Whitney had a very big personality. You know what I mean? And she was fun. Let's just face it. You know.
Fly amazing, you're there. Don't walk away from me.
Don't walk away from me. Listen, you heard what she said.
I have nothing. I'm telling you. Treat you kind, and I hope you have on you dreamers.
It's tough to know you gotta let go of somebody because it's best for them, you know what I mean? And just knowing that you're not what they need. We can be selfish sometimes and stick around.
Hello, 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 y'all, and welcome to episode 10 of I Felt That. Hey, it's your girl Tera Nashay, and I'm back for episode 10 of I Felt That. And as y'all can see, I'm alone. And I decided, and I realized when I went to do episode 10, like, there was something special about episode 10 last season when I did it. And then I realized that I dedicated episode 10, me and special guest G Dunlap, to the king of R&B, Mr. R. Kelly. So I'm like, well, I want to kind of do something similar to that. And I realized, if y'all don't already see who's on my shirt, let me give y'all a little hint. Let me let y'all see. I hadn't done the queen of pop. And this is a pop and R&B podcast. And she's one of my faves. And she's the GOAT. And she's one of the greatest of all times. So I wanted to go ahead and dedicate episode 10 to none other than Miss Whitney Houston. Yes. Rest in peace to Miss Whitney Houston. But like I just said, she is the GOAT. So, and I just wanted to take the time to give her the recognition that she deserves for being the beautiful person that she is. Like I said, she was an amazing soul. And just to see her growing up in her prime and always in the limelight, always, you know, doing something, it was a joy. It was a joy. So I just wanted to go ahead and take time and give Miss Whitney Houston her flowers. So Miss Whitney Houston was from New Jersey. She was discovered in 1977, so she's been around for a minute. She's a singer, actress, film producer, a philanthropist, record producer, songwriter. She did pop, R&B, gospel, dance. She did it all. Soul. She did it all. Like, she was, well, she had her hands in a lot of different areas, as you can see. She won 8 Grammys. She was one of the best selling entertainers of all times. I think she sold over 220 million records total. Like, she was that girl. Like, seeing her at a young age up into an adult, older, you know, still being that girl. Like, I love her in Sparkle. She played the mom in Sparkles, one hell of a role. I think that might have been one of the last movies that she actually did act in before she passed away in 2012. And that was a tragedy. It was a very, very sad time and moment for everybody that was a fan and everybody that knew her and everybody that, would, like I said, was able to witness her over the years grow and go through different things. So I can honestly say she started out singing in the church, which a lot of some of the best artists do, start out in the church. She was in love with Mr. Bobby Brown. They had a very toxic and loving relationship, you know. If you know, you know. We've all been there, I'm pretty sure. We can relate. And she played in a lot of different movies. One of the movies that I enjoyed the most was Preacher's Wife. I love that movie, Preacher's Wife. Waiting to Exhale. The Bodyguard. I remember that one growing up too. Her and Kevin Costner, I think it was. And she was, listen, I'm just going to say this. Whitney had a very big personality. You know what I mean? And she was funny. Let's just face it. You know, whether she was in her right frame of mind at the time or whatever it was that she was going through, she was still funny. Like, I don't care. People say that she was, you know, under the influence. Whether she was or not, that was funny. She was a funny, funny person. But honestly, like I said, she was an actress, and that's when you got to see the side of her that I think really showed her the most, who she actually was, who she truly was, seeing her personality in The Preacher's Wife, seeing her personality in Waiting to Excel, in Bodyguard, you know what I mean? Seeing her acting in those ways, that shows you who the real Whitney Houston was. And one of my favorite moments that comes to mind for me, seeing her when she was younger, is when she sung the Star Spangled Banner at one of the NFLs. I think it was in 1970-something. I don't remember when. But when I tell you she did that, she did that. And that's one of my favorite moments that I remember. So I'm going to go ahead and play a clip of her singing that, because one of the most powerful voices, let's talk about it, Miss Whitney Houston. Cannot be matched. Cannot be matched. So, and she started out earlier. Beautiful, just a beautiful soul. You know, just a powerful, beautiful voice. You know, she seems like she just gave off good energy. I think she had a TV show, her and Bobby, that I watched years ago. You know, and she was just funny. Again, you can tell she was a loving mother, you know. I can't imagine what her mom is going through, losing both her and Bobby Christina, you know, in the same way. You know, I know that has to be a lot for her to process and deal with and go on with her life knowing that that's what happened to them. But I'm sorry, but you just have to love her. You know what I mean? You just have to love her. Look at that smile on my shirt, on the background. I mean, you know, like I said, started out early. So I'm going to pick three of my favorite Whitney Houston songs. There's a lot more out there, but these are my three of my favorites just from her that I enjoyed listening to over the years and that I still listen to now, present. So the first song, it came out in 1987 off of the album Whitney, and it's called I Wanna Dance with Somebody. And it was a classic. It's one of her songs that she was very young when it came out. I don't think it was her debut album, but it was one of her new, it was the album from when she was fresh into the entertainment business and the light of us, you know, being a part of watching her. And the song is just about, it's an upbeat song, and it just makes you want to dance hearing it. And it just gives you, it's a funky, catchy little, you know, beat, and it just gives you a good vibe. And there's a part of the song, I like the chorus too. Again, it goes into the chorus. So, she's, I need a man to take a chance on a love that burns hot enough to last. And when the night falls, my lonely heart calls. Oh, I wanna dance with somebody. I wanna feel the heat with somebody. Oh, I wanna dance with somebody. With somebody who loves
Somebody, ooh, somebody, ooh. Oh, I love it. So I'm going to go ahead and play a little bit of Miss Whitney Houston singing my absolute, one of my favorite faves from her way back when. She was that deal. She really was. So Miss Whitney Houston, I Want to Dance with Somebody. And let's go.
I need a man to take a chance on love at first, hard enough to last. So when the night falls, the lonely heart falls, oh, I want to dance with somebody. I want to feel the heat with somebody. Yeah, I want to dance with somebody. With somebody who loves.
Don't play with Whitney. And she even said in the song that she's trying to find a way to chase her blues away. Is that what she said? She's trying to figure out how to chase her blues away. And dancing the night away, you know, and just forgetting about all your worries and everything that's going on and bothering you is one of the best ways to do that. And she said, listen, she wanna dance with somebody who loves her. And that makes it all the while better. So much better when you're dancing and living that moment, having that moment with somebody that loves you. You know what I mean? Dancing the night away, forgetting about all your worries, problems, troubles, letting your hair down, getting some fresh air. You know what I mean? Getting a peace of mind, just letting it all loose, you know? So yes, I want to dance with somebody. That was one of my absolute faves from Miss Whitney Houston. And okay, so the next two songs both came off of the same album in 1992, and it was actually a soundtrack, the Bodyguard soundtrack. So two of my faves came off of that soundtrack. That movie, again, like I said, was with Kevin Costner. It was an absolute fave. He was her bodyguard. She was a star, like she is, and like she was, and they actually almost fell in love, basically. And they spent a lot of time together, and they became, you know, close and developed a good relationship between the two. And so the second song that I'm reflecting off, the first song off of that soundtrack that I'm reflecting off of is called I Have Nothing. And honey, let me tell you, this one right here, it's just about her telling him, her lover,
that he's her everything and she's nothing. She has nothing if she doesn't have him. And it's a powerful message. Powerful message that she delivered in that song. And you couldn't help but feel it. You couldn't help but play it over and over again. Like I said, she has one of the most powerful voices that I've heard. And they classified her as a pop singer, but I don't think she was more R&B. She could have been both, honestly. Both to me, honestly. But the song, the part of the song that I felt the most was when she said, "Don't make me close my door. I don't want to hurt anymore. Stay in my arms if you dare. Must I imagine you there? Don't walk away from me. I have nothing, nothing, nothing. If I don't have you, if I don't have you." Oh gosh, I can't hit it like Whitney though. Y'all know I can't sing it like Whitney Houston. You know, I might hold a note, you know, but I can't do it like Miss Houston. And I would never even try. But that's my song, though. You know what I mean? That's my song. You know, she made that for me and for you. You know, so we can't help but try to sing it the best that we can. And there's another part of the song that I like. Obviously, the whole song I like. But another one of my favorite parts is when she said, "I don't really need to look very much further. I don't wanna have to go where you don't follow. I'm in this passion side. Can't run from myself. There's nowhere to hide." Okay, I'm go ahead and let Whitney sing it because I ain't finna mess her song up like that, but yes, I have nothing. Miss Whitney Houston. Let's go. Heard what she said. I have nothing, nothing, nothing. you heard what she done said now. You heard what she had to say now. Miss Whitney hadn't spoke. She said, listen, I'm telling you. Listen, I'm being firm. I'm standing on business. I say what I said. Don't walk away from me. You know, you're all I need. I don't need to look very much further. I don't want to go where you don't follow, meaning I don't want to be without you. Like, I want you to be following me or me following you or whatever the case is. I just want us to be together, basically. And I have nothing without you. I mean, that's just all I can say. I mean, I felt that. You got to feel that. You know, when you got somebody that make you feel that way, you know, that you have an unmatched vibe or an unmatched connection with and make you feel like you don't want to be without them, like, yeah, you don't want to leave them. It makes you feel like, you know, you don't want to be without them. You have nothing without them. So that's how you know it's real, you know? And I felt that. You got something like that, you don't want to lose it, you know? That don't come. That's not going to come. It should come naturally, one thing I can say, but you don't get that all the time, put it like that. You know, that's like a once in a lifetime type of thing. And sometimes it takes for you to be away from that and, you know, you try to find that in somebody else. Everybody after that, you're trying to find somebody to match that bond that you have with somebody else, and you, oh, it's not like so-and-so, it's not like, you might not find that again. You know what I mean? Sometimes you just ain't gonna get that same person again. So you gotta appreciate it. You gotta recognize and realize when you got something like that with somebody, you know, you need to probably stick it out with that person. And again, sometimes it takes for you to have somebody after that to realize what you really want. Like, oh, this ain't that. Even a few people like that, at the end of the day, you know, it don't make me feel how I felt when I was with her or him, you know, it don't give me that same complete feeling. It don't make me feel like, okay, I'm safe here with this situation, you know? So, yeah, that's that. So, I have nothing. Absolute classic, absolute fave. We're gonna go ahead and get into the other song, which is my third and final song that I'm reflecting on today, and it's also off of the Bodyguard soundtrack, like I said, and it's probably, in my opinion, I don't know for sure if this is true, but in my opinion, it's her number one hit. It's probably the song that people know her for the most, and it's I Will Always Love You. And baby, let me tell you, this one right here wasn't to be played with. When I say sunk her heart out on this, she let you hear every part of her voice that she had available to allow us to hear on this one right here. She reached down from the depths of her soul with this one, and I absolutely love it. It's a classic. It's a song about her having to leave her lover knowing that she's not what's best for him, basically. And knowing it's best for him for her to go, you know? And just telling him that she'd always love him, knowing that they can't be together. But she would always love him. And that's deep. That's real deep right there. And the part of the song that I felt the most was when she went into the second verse. And she said, with a sweet memory, that is all I'm taking with me. So goodbye. We both know I'm not what you need, and I will Like, that's my cut. Like, that's my jam right there. I was so young when it came out, but I just remember my sisters. I just remember the radios blasting that over and over and over again. And it was just like, oh my God, her voice is amazing. Who is this? Like, I want to sing this song like her. Like, I want to be like Whitney Houston. I never forget y'all. Back in the day in elementary school, when we would get ready to take our school pictures, they would really do a good job, life touch. They would really do a good job of hyping us up. You know what I mean? Getting us, making us confident to go in here and take these pictures, you know? And I'll never forget one year I went up in there and my mama had to put the rollers in my hair the night before. You know, curls was curling, popping, all that, right? You know, I'm getting ready to go in because I don't know why back then, but we used to dress up like we was going to church. Well, at least my mama, maybe because my mom was a little older. But anyway, I had my little church dress on and you couldn't tell me nothing already, okay? Them folks hadn't hyped me up. Come on, we got Miss Whitney Houston. You look just like Whitney Houston. If you would have seen me marching my little black, you know what, up there to that chair to sit my ass down, you could tell me, what? They give you the little combs to make sure everything is in place. And they hadn't told Whitney who? Oh, okay. 1, 2. He's going to be the best pictures ever. You hear me? But, yeah, she was beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful. So, gotta love Miss Whitney Houston. I'll go ahead and play that for y'all. Like I said, I'm not Whitney Houston. I'm nowhere near. Like, she's the GOAT. You can't compare to the greatest, the queen of pop. You can't compare to that. So, go ahead, Miss Whitney Houston. I will always love you. Let's go. Had to hit y'all with the intro. Listen to what she said.
I would only be your way. So I would, but I know I'll think of you.
That beautiful voice. So soft and pure.
Love.
Child, as they used to say back in the day, all I can say is I felt that. Like, because it's tough to know you gotta let go of somebody because it's best for them. You know what I mean? And just knowing that you're not what they need. We can be selfish sometimes and stick around knowing that we ain't good for nobody, or knowing that this person ain't good for us, but we just allowing it to continue because, you know, we're scared to let go. But you won't grow that way if you don't let go of stuff that's not for you. If you don't, you know, remove things like that from your life, you know, things that you know that you don't need. How do you expect yourself to grow? You know, you gotta, in order to receive your blessings, you gotta get rid of the things that ain't for you and make room, you know, for those blessings and those new things to come. And, you know, you gotta be able to receive it. If you ain't there to receive the blessings, then you can't get it. It's just simple. And sometimes you just gotta make space in your life and get rid of things like that and just, you know, face the fact that sometimes this might not be what you want to do, but if that's what's best for you, you have to do that. And you have to face the fact sometimes and just look at the big picture, like, look, it's just ain't it. You know, and you have to look out for other people too sometimes. If they ain't strong enough to leave on their own, sometimes you got to let go of them. And it's love, you know what I mean? It's like, you know, you need to grow. You ain't where you need to be right now. You know what I mean? You need to work on you. You need to focus on you, you know? And at the end of the day, what kind of person would I be to hold you back from something that I know that you really need? You know what I mean? What type of person would I be to allow you not to be a better person and for you to not go and get what it is that you truly need and truly do deserve, you know? So, and sometimes when you with people, they will cloud up your judgment. You know what I mean? If, you know, you need to be focusing on something else, but here you are focusing on something that ain't gonna help you personally in life to get where you're going, you know? And sometimes things can be a distraction to you. So you just have to be able to identify when that's the case. You know, you have to be able to pay attention, you know? Hey, you gotta be honest with yourself. It starts with you. Be honest with yourself, like, is this something that I know that I really need? Is it, you know, okay, where is this? Take the time to analyze situations, just put it that way. So, I felt that, absolute classic, Miss Whitney Houston. You can never be duplicated, you can never be replaced. Like I said, just seeing that smile, and just if you go and watch her interviews, just funny, just entertaining. She was an entertainer, hands down, regardless. She was fearless, you know, she didn't let anything stop her from being who she was. And that's one thing, like, I can say that I love the most about Whitney Houston, was she was who she was, and, you know, she didn't let nobody stop her from being who she wanted to be or doing what she wanted to do. And that's just how you have to live your life sometimes, you know? And yeah, so thank you guys for taking the time out to sit with me and reflect while I reflected on Miss Whitney Houston and her great music that she's provided over all these many, many years. Like I said, we still jamming to it, listening to it, loving it. And generations to come, for sure. Y'all, like I said, this is the end of episode 10, special episode 10. And it, believe it or not, y'all, we only have, or is this, hold on, y'all. Yeah. We only have 2 episodes left, do I want to say? Oh, man, dang, I didn't realize we were down to just 2 episodes. So the next 2 guests that you guys will see are no stranger to I Felt That. They've been on here before on season 1. So you can look forward to 2 more familiar faces that's going to come back and rock it out, knock it out of the park, and shut it down for the end of season 2. I'm so excited, guys, and looking forward to the season finale, where I'm going to be bringing back if not all of my guests from the past two seasons, majority of the guests that you guys enjoy that's came to rock with, I felt that and make it what it is. You know what I mean? It wouldn't be what it is without the wonderful guests that come on and bless, you know, the set with their presence. So I appreciate all my guests that came through, been rocking with me since day one, that rocked it out with me on season two. We're doing it big for the season finale. Y'all just stay tuned because it's a movie, for sure. It's a movie. And we're going to show y'all how we do it here in the Quad Cities. You know what I mean? Look, y'all, for season three, we're really stepping it up. Like, your girl been working. Your girl been making things happen. Like, I when we pop off with season three, y'all gonna be like, okay, Tera Nashay. Okay, I felt that. Yes, you guys are really gonna love it. So we have a lot in store. Just, like I said, keep rocking with your girl. Y'all, I appreciate everybody that tuned in for this episode. Like, share, comment, subscribe to I Felt That if you haven't already. And be on the lookout for episode 11, and be on the lookout for a new old guest. And like I said, I appreciate y'all. I love y'all. And guess what, y'all? I felt that.